In this question, you're told that Mrs. Bahati has been operating a retail business since 2010. She does not keep proper books of account for the year ended 31st December 2012. Then you're given the accounts there and additional information. And you're asked, compile Mrs. Bahati's taxable profit or loss for the years ended 31st December 2010, 2011 and 2012. Okay, so how should we go about it? The first thing that we have to do is determine the movement in net assets. Okay, now we're already given the net assets position, which is basically capital. It is this 1.6, 1.7, 2.3. So the movement between these two dates is going to be assumed to be the taxable income. Okay, so let's do it so that you see it. Working number one, the movement in net assets. In net assets. So here we are not having to draw the capital statement showing all the assets and liabilities. Yeah, you can just draw a timeline showing the balance on 31st Dec 2010, 31st Dec 2011, and 31st Dec 2012. So you just show the balance for the year. Just look at the movement between the two dates. So in this year ended 2011, the movement is an increase of 100,150, and in this year ended 2012, the movement is 665,450. Okay, that is the first thing that we have to do. After we do that, we now go through the other notes and see what we have. So the first thing we can notice here are personal expenses. Some of the personal expenses will be allowed and others may be disallowed. But let's just read through and see. Repairs, blah, blah, all these. So the key thing here is that these 96,000, 144, 192, 228, and 163 have already been categorized as being personal. So I cannot now come and start determining whether a portion of them are business related. So we'll just go by what we have been given and assume all of it is personal and add it back, isn't it? So this becomes our working number two. Personal expenses. So we make a note that they are disallowed and therefore they are added back to the profits. Okay, so let's just tabulate them so that you get the totals. We have 2011, we have 2012. So we have the house repairs of 96,000, nothing there. We have salaries for domestic workers. Of 144,000 in the first year and 168,000 in the second year. Then we have cash drawings of 192 and 220. Then we have conveyance fees of 228 and nil there. Then we have general expenses of 163 and 331,600. So when we add them up, 823,719. Okay, so these ones we shall add them up. Yeah. Okay, we go to the next one, which is on non-business receipts. So non-business receipts, what do we have? We're told that there was an inheritance So this one should be added back. We have rental income. Now rental income, even if it's not related to the main business you are running, even if it's from a side a hustle or whatever it is, this one must be taxed. So this one we shall not deduct. Then interest from bank deposits, the withholding tax is deemed to be the final tax whenever you're dealing with interest given to individuals. So this one we have to make that adjustment. So working number three, non-business receipts. Are not taxable and therefore so the inheritance and interest on bank deposits so it's good just mention that rental income is taxed. Therefore, there is no adjustment. And also that withholding tax to individuals is final tax. So withholding tax on interest, yeah. If the interest had been paid to an corporate body, then would have grossed up the interest, tax it, and then give it, give credit for the withholding tax already deducted. Eh? So that's a point where many students usually forget. Then finally, you're told that for the years ended 31st December 2011 and 2012, salaries paid to the husband amounted to 312 and 480. So these ones are not allowed. So we add back. So in 2011 it was 312 and then became 480,000, isn't it? We can now solve for the question. The question is asking us to compile Mrs. Bahati's taxable profit or loss for the 2 years. So taxable profit or loss. So I'm just going to have the 2 years side by side. So I first start by the movement in net assets. Which was from my working one. And the movement was 100, 150, and 665 for 50. We go now to the second note on personal expenses, which are adding, we are adding back. And we go to the third one, where we're deducting the non-business receipts. Then we have the salary to husband, which we're going to add back. So that gives you your total taxable income. And with that, we have solved for what the examiner required, and we're able to get our full marks of 8. That brings us to the end of this question.